So today I'm going to be reviewing the install and testing of Moose Racing's Onyx footpegs with the half-inch offset. Our test mule is going to be the good old 2006 Suzuki DR-Z400s. Let's face it, the stock Suzuki footpegs are pretty horrendous. Pretty much the first thing everyone does with them is remove the rubber centerpieces, so your boot will at least grip something. But the stock pegs are pretty narrow and short, which usually means the second mod is to replace them with something wider and spikier. I didn't want to lose any of the room between my footpeg and the shifter, so Moose's half-inch back offset footpegs sounded like they'd be the perfect solution for my application. So here's the packaging. I ordered for the 2006 DRZ, and it appears what showed up at my door was the right part. They claim to be made from a 17-4 stainless steel that's been hardened. The casting quality looks pretty good, and they're pretty heavy. The platform is about 90 millimeters long and 55 millimeters wide. There's a convex shape to the top of the platform and lots of voids for mud clearing. The teeth aren't that sharp, but for a dual sport it should be just about right, providing decent grip while allowing for foot movement without tearing up the soft soles of the ADV style boots I like to wear. Removing the left Suzuki peg is a piece of cake. First, remove the cotter pin and washer. Then, take a small pair of pliers and remove the stock spring from the foot peg and the frame. Pull out the pin and remove the foot peg. Just a little side note here, this small pair of bent nose pliers worked great for removal and install of the foot peg springs. So here's the difference between the stock Suzuki foot peg on the left and the Moose Onyx on the right. Yeah, I was pretty stoked at this point, but then we started having some issues. The first problem I ran into was that the factory pin wouldn't fit back into the Moose foot peg. I figured it was because the finish on the Moose pegs is pretty thick. The Suzuki pin is 10 millimeters in diameter, so I took a 25/64 inch drill bit and chased the holes, cleaning out the paint. Since these pegs are made from stainless, it's no big deal, since it'll resist rusting, and besides, I grease all the friction surfaces during reassembly. My method for installing the foot peg spring is to put the pin in through the foot peg and frame mount until it just protrudes from the other side of the peg mount. Then I put the spring's hook end in the foot peg and use the bent nose pliers to bring the straight end of the spring up and put it into the frame hole. Once the spring is in the peg and the frame, I tap the pin the rest of the way through the spring coil. Put on the washer and install a new cotter pin. Easy peasy. Just make sure you wear eye protection as the spring can shoot out if you lose your grip with the pliers. I was happy to see that the half inch offset on the Moose pegs left the leading edge of the new pegs right about where the factory peg was, leaving me the same gap I'm used to for my boot toe. The Suzuki foot peg springs were reused per the Moose instructions, and everything seemed to work great on the left side, but then I went to the right side. On the right side of the bike, you have to remove the rear brake arm in order to remove the foot peg pin. To get the arm off, you'll need to remove a cotter pin on the back of the bolt that holds the brake arm on. There's also a thrust washer between the arm and the frame. It'll probably be stuck to one part or the other when you take the arm off. Just make sure you account for it and put it back in when you go to reassemble. Everything on the right side install went nice and smooth until I lifted the Moose foot peg up to test the spring and noticed that it stopped about halfway up on its normal travel against the rear brake arm. Now, maybe some people will be fine with that, but I seem to drop my bike at least once a ride off-road, and I don't like the idea of the aluminum brake arm becoming the foot peg stop. The stop should be the lip on the mounting boss that's in the frame. I was worried that if I dropped the bike on that side, there might be a lot of stress introduced onto that rear brake arm. Those arms are like $140 to replace, and bending or breaking it in the field might make for an eventful day. So after thinking about it for a while, I decided that there was enough material and support built into the Moose foot peg to get away with clearance grinding it just enough to clear the brake arm and reach the frame stop. This process took me a while, and I ended up removing more material than I really wanted to. I went slowly and carefully, fitting, marking, grinding, and repeating that process until I had it clearanced. I did a tiny bit of radiusing on the brake arm too. I filed out all the grinding marks, sanded the area with some emery cloth, and then painted it. I was actually pretty happy with how clean it turned out. I feel reasonably confident that there's enough material left in the corner that it won't collapse under me, and it should hold up to a hit pretty well if I drop it. So what are my riding impressions? Well, I really like them. The convex shape lets me transition to the shifter or brake really easily. They feel grippy without feeling like my feet are stuck to the pegs. It's night and day difference when I'm standing on these platforms versus the narrow factory pegs. I feel a lot more comfortable and in control now when standing. I guess I'm just a little torn on how to review these. I hate the fact that I had to bust out the grinder and remove material to make these work correctly, but at the same time I really like the feel and that they maintain the toe room to my shifter and brake controls. I know Moose is using the same casting for a lot of different models, but I think they should have addressed that brake arm clearance issue. Like I said earlier though, if you're not concerned about the brake arm, they'll fit just fine. Thanks for watching my video. Check out my channel for other motorcycle related videos and playlists. As always, like votes, new subscribers, and sharing the video on social media and moto forums all help me to keep making more of these videos. Thanks!